Father's house, Jesus is the way to my Father's house. There is joy, joy, joy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters who participate worthily in this Eucharistic celebration, let us call to mind our sin and ask God's pardon and mercy. And let us together say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask you, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us silently pray for our private intentions. Today the Church celebrates the memoria of St. John Bosco. Let us in this Eucharistic celebration pray for all the Salesian priests, especially those who are working in and around Panjim. Let us pray. O God, who raised up the priest St. John Bosco as a father and teacher of the young, grant, we pray, that aflame with the same fire of love, we may seek out souls and serve you alone. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope and consider how to stir up one another to love. Brethren, since we have confidence to enter the sanctuary by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way which he opened for us through the curtain, that is through his flesh, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful, and let us consider how to stir up one another to love good works, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. The word of God. Your response will be, such are the men who seek your face, O Lord. Please repeat. Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord. The Lord is the earth and its fullness, the world and all its people. It is he who set it on the seas, on the waters he made it firm. Your response? Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord. Who shall climb the mountain of the Lord? Who shall stand in his holy place? The man with clean hands and pure heart, who desires not worthless things. Your response? Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord. He shall receive blessings from the Lord and reward from the God who saves him. Such are the men who seek him, seek the face of the God of Jacob. Your response? Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord. Please stand for the acclamation. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Jesus said to his disciple, "Is a lamp brought in to put under a bushel or under a bed and not on a stand? For there is nothing hid except to be made manifest, nor is anything secret except to come to light. If any man has ears to hear, let him hear." And he said to them, "Take heed what you hear. The measure you give will be the measure you get, and still more will be given to you. For to whom has, more will be given. And from him who has not, even what he has will be taken away." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, today's gospel contains a word of caution. When Jesus says, "Take heed of what you hear. Pay attention to what you hear." My dear brothers and sisters, there are many voices around us that are competing to gain our attention. But we have to focus only on the voice of our Lord. The true voice, the real voice, will lead us to Jesus. But the false voice, the flattery words, the filthy words, the false words, will lead us away from Jesus. Today's gospel also contains a word of good counsel. When Jesus says, "The one who has, more will be given." My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord wants that we should share what we have with others. The Lord has given us the privilege to be proclaimers of his gospel. And in fact, gospel is the only commodity whose value increases when we share it with others. The more we share the gospel truth with others, the more the Lord reveals it to us. And finally, today's gospel also contains a word for consideration. Those who do not have, what they have will also be taken away. If you refuse to use your talents and gifts to serve the Lord, if you ignore his call, if you waste the talents that he has given you, he will withdraw or take away all that you have. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, today as we reflect on this gospel, let us pay attention to these three things: the caution, the good counsel, and the consideration. May this help us to follow Jesus more closely.
Hymn number B23 on page 73.
Take our hearts.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and for the good of all His holy Church. Accept our offering, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of St. John Bosco, you bid your Church rejoice. So too you strengthen her by the example of His holy life. Teach her by His word of preaching and keep her safe in answer to His prayers. And so with the company of saints and angels, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy,
holy Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Philip Neri our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, this is Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Happy are all those who are called for the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
unworthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glorify you in our gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Amen.